one by one, line by, row by row, go out those doors, and get outside, I'll show you the trick. So within a few minutes, he had this whole theater empty, without any panic at all. He walked outside, saw they were all safe, collapsed in tears, and then they eventually finished the show. Late in his life, he was asked, what's the greatest trick you ever did? He said, I made 1,000 kids disappear from the theater. So this is that theater. As time goes on, into more modern times, B.B. King, Muddy Waters, they played here, David Jones from among these. So the theater was fairly active for a long time, and all of that stuff is marked as well. I don't want to get too specific about the ghosts, only because we honestly don't know who all these people are, but they are numerous, and they do date back to 1915 and even maybe before. The most common sightings are people up in the balcony and the mezzanine, shadowy figures seen right around where that letter A is. We've seen them on our home theater crews. There have been a lot of reports in the back hallway, all the way upstairs, of a woman who appears to be wearing a nightgown, and that has to be a nightgown. In this corner of the balcony, a woman sits and watches the stage. We hear footsteps, we hear voices, and chairs as we pull up and down, but that's not going to happen tonight. And a lot of different things. We've been bringing tours in here for 25 or 6 years now, and things happen on the tours. You don't want us to worry about the psychic lady? I don't know. This happened. We picked up a tour across town. And does anybody psychic here? This lady tells me before the tour even starts that she's a psychic, and she's going to tell me everything that happens to me. And I'm like, oh, yay! And she starts screaming at cars and houses, and I have to tell her to shut up. We finally get here, and the bus driver for that night was not going to come into the building. She was terrified of the building. And I said, you have to come in tonight, because that lady's going to freak out. And she did. She was nuts. I'm up on the stage, and I'm talking, and the lights are low, and they have a ghost light on, so there's one light. And she's dying to say something. You can see it. She's like, she said, there's one on the stage there. And I turned, there's not. And I just keep talking, and then another audience member, I don't know the people very well, so I won't tell you exactly what he said, but it was something like, he was a ghost. And I turned around, and there was a guy standing there, like 6 feet behind me. And I become the very first tour guide in the history of the company, and I met on the whole group, and they all were just staring at me when I turned around. And I went, y'all saw that, right? And they were done. Another night we had a guy up here on the mezzanine up here, and I was on the stage, and I was pointed it out, everybody turned, he disappeared, everybody ran to the door, and he went, you can't see that. The things happened. There were bad people, the theater, or they didn't do it. None of them ever been proven to be dangerous in anything, but it was pretty loud. So, what you see tonight, if you see anything, is it pretty? I'm sorry, you'll be the second person to go out there. You'll be the second.
I kind of grew up here at the theater. When I was a little kid, we were coming here to go to the movies 40 years ago. So I've always been around this theater, and when it closed down and they reopened it to, try to open it back up and use it for things, it was this that opened and closed. I don't know how many times in the last 25, 30 years. And I got involved in it early on and have had, and I'm not, if you guys have read any of my books or have seen me do stuff, I am not a psychic. I do not talk to dead people. I don't see dead people, none of that stuff. But I've had more experiences here in this building than probably most of the other places that I've traveled all around the country combined. It is a really active spot. We rarely ever have an event here that doesn't have activity. And I'm not telling you that. We can't guarantee it, obviously. This isn't a sure thing, but we almost always do. My favorite story. Well, let me take you off onto the stage. You guys, why don't you use that staircase up here? And let me bring you up here onto the stage. how everything in the theater, just like any whole theater, is all focused here on the stage, which has always made me believe that in most theaters that are haunted, and as far as I'm concerned, this is one of the most haunted in the entire country. In fact, it's one of the most haunted places in the country, in my opinion. But you could see how everything channels toward the stage. So you get a lot of activity on the stage because this is a part of the building where a lot of people leave energy behind. There have been a lot of things, and some of the first things I ever experienced here was working up here on the stage and hearing footsteps come up across the stage and then discovering there was no one there. And that seems to be a pretty common thing here. Back in 1995, some of you weren't even born yet, I don't think. Back in 1995, I had just gotten started with the Haunted Decatur tours the year before. And we were just started kind of putting Decatur, I don't know, on the map, I guess, with haunted places. And I still lived here. I had the TV channel out of Springfield wanted to do a week-long story on haunted places around Central Illinois. And they called me and asked me to be in the shows and to take them around in these different places. So we did some places in Springfield, we did some places in Decatur, one of them, of course, was here. And so I brought the news crew in with me, and when I say crew, I mean two people, a cameraman and a reporter. That much hasn't changed. So we came in, and we got here into the theater, and we walked around, and I told them the stories and the things that were supposed to happen. And I talked about this staircase, this spiral staircase here that goes up to, right now it's just this big room up here, was a big heating and cooling room. It used to go on to other parts of the building back in the day, but it doesn't anymore. But this particular spot has always been regarded as really haunted. There's been a lot of people who have no knowledge of the history of the theater who've had encounters and things that they've experienced around these stairs. They've heard things on them and they've seen people on them, figures on them that look completely real. For instance, the year before this news thing, there had been a music show that had here. It was a Patsy Cline tribute show where somebody, a lady, comes out, does Patsy Cline and stuff. And they had used this because it required a lot of costume changes. They didn't want to use the dressing rooms. Plus, they were not fixed up at the time. So they just set up a dressing area right back here in the corner of the stage. About halfway through the show, this is according to one of the managers here, but halfway through the show, one of the staff from the Patsy Cline show came up and said, listen, we got a problem with your employees. They said, well, really, they're all volunteers, but what is it, what's going on? He said, well, we've got a guy who is up on that staircase that is in the corner of the stage, and he's watching the girls change clothes. The manager said, well, seems really unlikely to me. I don't know how he'd get up there. You guys are using that corner. He said, but I can come take a look if you want. And so he came down and came across the back of the stage. The show was going on. And they said, yeah, we've seen him right here. We've seen him on that bend in the thing right there. And he said, well, is he up there now? And they said, yeah, we just saw him. And he's up there somewhere on the stairs. So Steve, the manager at the time, said, hey, we go to look, climb the stairs. If you know where this is going, there's no one there. But whoever this figure was, these people knew nothing about this theater, but they all were telling stories that other people had been telling. So, 1995, I've got this news crew in, and we finished filming everything that we needed to, and the cameraman said to me, hey, I thought maybe I'd go up to the top of that staircase and then I can get a view of the stage and everything from up high, and you want to go up with me? I said, sure. So we went on up the stairs. And we got up, we climbed up to the top of that concrete platform that's up there. He did what he needed to do. He got the shots, and we were just standing up there talking. So as we're talking, we heard the reporter who came with us, who said, I'm not wearing hard-soled shoes, but she was wearing hard-soled dress shoes. But we could plainly hear her coming up the stairs. I mean, it was unmistakable. So the cameraman, who had spent the entire week we've been together telling me, yeah, I don't believe in any of this stuff. It's all silly, but, you know, it is kind of fun, you know. And so I don't believe in ghosts. That was this big thing. So we were up there and we could hear her coming up the stairs. So he said, "Hey, Dana, can you see?" Because there was no light back here in the corner. It was really dark. And there were no lights on the stage. But he had the light on top of his camera. So he pointed it down the center shaft of the stairs. And he said, "Is that enough light? Can you see to come up?" Well, there's no answer. But we could still hear her coming up the stairs. And so he yells it louder. He says, "Hey, is that enough light? Can you see to come up?" Well, this time she answered. She went, "What?" We looked, and she's standing on the other side of the stage. We're the only three people here in the building. And he said, "Where are you?" And she steps out. She's right here. "Why?" And he says, "You're not on the stairs?" And she said, "No, I'm right here." And he said, "Well, who's on the staircase?" She said, "Well, I can see you guys up there." He goes, "No, on the stairs." And she said, "Nobody. There's no one on the stairs." And he said, "Well, can't you hear somebody walking?" And she said, "No, but we could both hear it, plain as day, coming up these stairs." And finally, he said, "Are you sure there's nobody on the stairs?" And she said, "Yes, there's no one there." And he shoved me out of the way, grabbed his camera, ran down the stairs, and went outside and would not come back into the building. But he did admit to me that, you know, "I don't believe in this stuff, but the Lincoln Theater made me a believer." And I've never forgotten that story. I've never forgotten the incident. And that was a long time ago. And I saw him about 3 or 4 years after that. The PBS station was doing a documentary, and they included the Lincoln. I told him that story, and they said, "What do you think he'd tell the story?" I said, "I doubt it. This guy was definitely not a believer in ghosts." And they said, "Well, you know, well, we'll call him and see." They called over the station. He goes, "Yeah, I'll be in it." He said, "I believe in ghosts now." So, it changed his mind. So anyway, this is a really cool building. I was so excited for us to be able to come back in here again. After it's been several years since we've been able to use it for anything, the tours or anything. It just sat here and it was rotting. And I had all these people who were contacting me going, "You know, is there anything that you could do? And I said, "We have tried. No one cares." And then Mark and Tasha and Lavelle got started on this stuff, and they got me involved in bringing back the ghost stuff here, and it's been a lot of fun so far, and I think tonight will be a continuation of that. But I will tell you one thing real quick, because we're going to shut the curtains to kind of muffle the noise between people investigating in the auditorium, people investigating the stage. But if you go out there to where the curtains are open right now, now is the time to take your picture of the auditorium, because it is a perfect view right now. So take it before we turn any lights off or before we close the curtains. And then we can meet back up into the lobby if you guys want, and then we're going to turn you loose here.